There's so many examples in popular culture where we're terrified. Movies about technologies that we can use to destroy ourselves in the future. The Matrix, The Terminator, we have Blade Runner. I was looking for these dystopian realities, but that's not what I found. And so I'm a journalist, I'm a reporter, I spent my life covering lots of things. There's so many things that would have sounded completely insane just a few years ago, and that in fact were so dubious that I wanted to look into them, and I was amazed to find out they're actually possible. Like, wow, it's possible to build bionic limbs? That's crazy. Wait, you can regrow a finger? Is that really possible? They can make a helmet that can read your thoughts? All of these things are things that people are actually trying to do. You know, what I found was, again and again, these technologies were being used to help people. And that's why we keep moving forward with it. My name is Adam Piore. My book is called The Bodybuilders: Inside the Science of the Engineered Human. I've always been fascinated by human resilience. And one of the things I discovered is that some of the most inspirational and powerful stories of human resilience are being unleashed and unlocked by technology. I heard about this guy who was a double amputee and had built himself bionic limbs that he was going to connect to his own nervous system. And I thought, I got to talk to this guy. He was considered like a rock climbing prodigy, but Hugh lost both his legs below the knees. Then one day, he decided, enough of this. He began tinkering with his prosthetics. He made little stumpy ones with bladed feet that could fit into crevices. Soon, he was an even better climber. Hugh began enrolling in college classes, and he began taking math and engineering classes. By the time he graduated, he had an acceptance letter from MIT. He ended up getting a PhD, and he began studying everything that was known about how our limbs work. And so he built a bionic limb.
I can even run. And that was the first demonstration of a running gait under neural command. Feels great.
You know, there's not just bionics. The last generation, the unknown was in the outside world, you know. We used our engineering prowess to send a man to the moon. We built bridges and skyscrapers and cars and planes. And now, in this generation, the unknown, the frontier, is really the human body and mind, and decoding it and understanding it down to the molecular level. And some of the most talented engineers of our generation are now pointing their sights inward to do that. And then hack into that to unleash untapped resilience or upgrade it. And you know, there's a military scientist I talked to who was in a program called Augmented Cognition. He oversaw it, and I said, are these technologies a good thing or a bad thing? Should we be scared of them or should we welcome them? And he said, well, it depends. You know, is a baseball bat a good thing or a bad thing? It's a good thing if you use it to play baseball with. It's a bad thing if you use it to beat somebody over the head with. But at its heart, where I saw these technologies applied, they were being used to help people. People who are facing challenges most of us can't even imagine, but refuse to give up and are teaching us something about where our limits lie and how we might overcome them. And I actually just found it really inspirational. This is taking us into uncharted territory in terms of the resilience that we can unlock and the good we can do to help people.